God's wisdom is oftentimes not one that we understand, yet it's all around us. Just as we were listening to the first reading, for those who came to Mass or do the readings, daily readings that the Church offers us, that's precisely what the Church is inviting us to do. To see that the wisdom of God is around us at all times. We might not understand it, and sometimes we might even come to think that the wisdom of God is no longer present. A few months ago, Patricia Wensky came up to me, ironically, sister, exactly where you were sitting at the retreat house, and said to me, "I need to see you before lunch is over." I thought, "Well, what do I do now?" And to my surprise, as many of you have heard before, it was to say that I was coming here to be before all of you. I didn't understand it, nor did I understand where God was leading. And to be quite frank, I didn't even know St. Matthew existed. So that, throw that in the pot. And here we are, several months later, celebrating a moment in the history of this parish. I may not have known Lucy, and I certainly don't know you, Lex, and I never got to meet Justin. Yet the wisdom of God has brought all three of us and this entire community here tonight. And when we ask why, I don't know. One thing that I can tell you that I am positive of, that the only reason why God gathers ever is out of love. And of that, I am convinced. I thank many people at the beginning, and I left out a certain group out, and that is all of you. I have to thank you because you have been in that wisdom of God, who God has placed in my life. And how wonderful how God brings people together for separate different reasons, and how beautiful things turn out. You came to see me at the office because you wanted to read again, which you did all your life. And we ended up talking about Justin, a young man who you said many times would walk into the house and found homeless people taking showers in your house, being fed by him, and being taken care of by him. What a wonderful thing, and what an honor it is to be the mother of a young man who wanted nothing but to show the love of Christ. I'm reminded over and over again of that gospel. Lord, when did we see you naked or hungry? When did we see you alone? When did we see you thirsty? When did we visit you? Whenever you did it for the least of mine, you did it for me. Today, there is an undertone, sadness and pain. That, you know, will always be there. A mother never forgets her child, as neither does a dad. But if there is one thing that both of you can be very happy about, is that the reason we are here tonight is because a young man by the name of Justin Lex Norris loved so much. That's exactly what we are emulating today. He loved basketball more than anything else. And underneath all of this is Justin's Miami Heat t-shirt. I promise you I would wear it. It's hot under here, I'll tell you that much. But it was a way of making Justin present even more. He wanted to build a basketball court. I thought about that. You came into my mind. And I saw lawsuits written all over the place. There was something that kept pushing me, and Maria knows that happens to me all the time, especially at funerals. There's something that happens inside of me, and I can never try to explain what it is because I can't, but I know when something needs to be said, and there's a voice that keeps growing louder and louder that says, "Say it, say it!" And I did. And I suggested this. And the reason why I suggested this is because just like the wisdom of God that's everywhere, some music envelops everything where it touches. I said at the beginning, the reason why the organ exists is to fill what words cannot. I believe beyond a shadow of a doubt that when we are before God, words are words. I believe we don't have to say anything because words get in the way. The great mystics oftentimes spoke of that same reality, that words kind of stumbled what they wanted to communicate with God. Yet music doesn't really need words, does it? We've heard music from different ages. We've heard lyrics from different languages. And yet, it moved all of us. Every single one of us. It touched each and every person here. And just like J was saying, for those of you who like Bach, You're going to love this. For those of you who don't, it'll only be 8 minutes. But it provokes something in us. Music provokes something in us. What I believe beyond shadow of a doubt is that it provokes a response. It provokes a desire to be able to express. Love doesn't need language. In fact, when two people love each other, words get in the way. A beautiful thing that today, what we celebrate, is that the wisdom of God and His love has brought all of us together tonight. For one purpose, to celebrate love. And even though that undertone of pain and sorrow is still there, the love of God always pulled us through. How beautiful that this evening prayer tonight began precisely with light. That's who God is. God is love, and God is a God of light. This instrument will be used in this church every single day. And it will be used for every single liturgical service that happens under this roof. Justin will continue to touch all of the people that come here. We will celebrate triumphantly on a celebration like Christmas and Easter. There will be moments where there will be people sorrowful, just like you today, who need to feel the love of God at that moment. And that instrument will help get them there. I wonder for my brothers and sisters that all of us, as a community, as a family, to know that the wisdom of God brought us here today. Many of you from different places, many of you originally from different states, maybe different countries, and here we are, and I am so very honored to be your pastor, and I am so very honored to be here tonight to mark a moment in the history of this parish. I thank you for the opportunity that you have given me to be here with you and to celebrate a moment of joy. Ask those of you to please come and let us ask God to bless this instrument that will speak a different language. It will speak the language of music, language of love. Ask those of you to come. As we bless this instrument, and I ask all of you to please stand. We dedicate this organ today. The dedication on this organ reads as follows. This organ was dedicated on this 17th day of November, 2017. In loving memory of Justin Lex Norris, by his parents, and as a reminder of Justin's unconditional love that continues to touch the hearts of everyone he came in contact with. That love will continue to be in contact with all who come here to St. Matthew. My dear brothers and sisters, we have come together to bless this new organ, installed so that the celebration of the liturgy may become more beautiful and solemn. The purpose of music in the liturgy is above all to give glory to God, to lead us to holiness. Thus, the music of the organ wonderfully expresses the new song that Scripture tells us to sing to the Lord. To sing this new song is to live rightly, to follow God's will eagerly and gladly, and by loving one another, carry out the new commandment that Jesus gave us.
Lord God, your beauty is ancient, yet ever new. Your wisdom guides the world in right order, and your goodness gives the world its variety and splendor. The choirs of angels join together to offer their praise by obeying your commands. The galaxies sing your praises by the pattern of their movement that follow your laws. The voices of the redeemed join in a chorus of praise to your holiness as they sing to you in mind and heart. We, your people, joyously gather in this church, wish to join our voices to the universal hymn of praise, so that our song may rise more worthily to your majesty. We present this organ for your blessing. Grant that its music may lead us to express our prayer and praise in melodies that are pleasing to you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
On behalf of this entire community.